When you think of pianist Oscar Peterson, you probably think of a sound kind of like this. Wait, what was that at the end? One more time. What was that at the very end? Okay, that's what we're talking about today. That last cadence into the tonic makes Oscar Peterson, Oscar Peterson. And if we want to know how we can get that sound for our own playing, we're gonna have to break it down. And that's what we're gonna do today. My name's Adam Maness, and today we're talking about Oscar Peterson's No 5-2-5. As always, this video is brought to you by Open Studio. You can go to openstudiojazz.com to go on a deeper dive. Also, a lot of what we're dealing with today is covered in a course that Peter Martin and I made called Language of the Masters. You can see all these great transcriptions in the course, and you can find a discount to that course in the description of this video. So before we get into the many examples that we have queued up for what Oscar is playing over these 5-1 cadences, let's talk about the where of what he's playing, because that is equally, if not more important than what he's playing. Every single instance of this No 5-2-5 that we're going to talk about happens at the end of a major phrase. So we have a lot of blues tunes here, right? The 12-bar blues form, and it happens there in bar 9 and bar 10, leading into the resolution of the tonic chord, right? We also have some examples from a non-blues tune, and it happens over a 3-6-2-5 at the end of a section, like a major A section, right? Or the end of the form completely. That's where he throws in this No 5-2-5. It's incredibly important to recognize that. This doesn't really work as well, you know, right at the top of a tune, even if there is a 2-5 right there. That's not what this is about. This is more of an exclamation point kind of a phrase. This is something that you can use as punctuation to really drive home the point that here we are at the end of an idea, and it is simply brilliant the way Oscar Peterson threads these through his solos. It really adds some weight to the end of phrases, to the end of sections. It helps to establish the form, and it helps to bring his listener down very gently and beautifully at the end of each phrase. Now that we know when Oscar uses this No 5-2-5, let's look at what it isn't. It's not functional harmony. It is not the paint-by-numbers, outline the chord changes kind of playing that you get from the last 30 or 40 years of improvisational instruction or from goofy-ass YouTubers. It is not this. It is not even this. It's not even this, where you're outlining, you know, like an altered sound or the tritone substitution sound. It's none of those things. Throw your preconceived notions about outlining chords as a way to bring your listener home. Throw those out the window, because that's not what we're doing here. What we are doing is this. We're still building tension, even with this, which is what I'm calling a heavy tonic sound. The five is just the one. I think that's Barry Harris's voice in the back of my head as I said that, because that's something that musicians from that generation preach to us again and again and again, and maybe someday we'll all get it, that the five is just the one. And Oscar proves that throughout this solo here from this live recording of CJM Blues. It happens like 6 times during his long solo, and we can learn from that. So let's look at this first bit of language that we heard. Let's listen to it here. Did you hear it? There it was. Let's hear it again. Listen one more time to what Oscar plays here. Okay, so what is going on here? So check it out. So we have a D7 on the 2 chord. This is in the key of C, of course, it's CJM Blues. So this 2 chord is a D7. That's notable because every single 2 chord we're going to hear Oscar Peterson play today, he makes into a dominant 7. It's not a minor 7. He plays a dominant 7. But look at what he does on this dominant 7. how C major is this? This is why this is a heavy tonic sound. Look at the big movements here. Right on beats one, on beats three, on beats one. That's a C major triad. And then look what he does right there at the beginning of the five chord. That's down a C6 chord. Then he does this, and you can see there is a G major triad at the end, but that's not how I think he's, I mean, he's not thinking that, right? This is more of, it's this movement, the B flat, the B to the C, to the tonic, creating a little bit of tension there at the end, but then down right back into like a C6 sound. But this is so heavy on the tonic. It's so heavily C. That couldn't be more C. Right? This G clashing over maybe the F sharp on the D7. That feels so much. It definitely doesn't feel like, you know, something like so spelled out of, you know, these spelled out versions of 2-5-1s. That's not what goes on here in Oscar Peterson's brain as he's resolving these things. Now, he does do that in other places, but it is a big part of his sound, this heavy tonic sound, right? This not outlining the five chord. Sometimes he'll outline the two chord, but he almost never in these situations outlines the five chord. He uses this first technique, the heavy tonic sound. It's all over the C-Jam Blues, but it's all over Oscar Peterson's career. Here's an excerpt from Bag's Groove from his album Night Train. I mean, this is one of the greatest albums of Oscar's career. And this is, again, at the end of a chorus. It's a blues, right? It's a blues in G. So you can see here we're setting up the two, which is, again, A7, that dominant sound. And listen to this. This is, again, a heavy tonic sound here. Check it out. You know what I mean? That's all tonic. Now he's starting to put, you know, the sound of the blues in there as well, which we're going to talk about next. But it's still, if you look at this, it's not just, you know, the sound of the blues is running the blues scale. There is a serious G vibe going on in this entire phrase. Look at that. The first thing that happens on the two chord on the A7. Right? That's a G triad that we're spelling out. He does it again. Again, coming down here at the end of the phrase on the five chord, that's a G6 chord. And that's how he resolves it. This screams to me G major, G6, however you want to think about it, but it does not scream, you know, all of these like very intricate bebop cadences that you could get into, which Oscar knew and played too, but this is, I think, more indicative of the sound that we're talking about here. Let's listen to Oscar play it again. Amazing. You know, so that's happening there at the end of a phrase at a 2-5, but you could hear that phrase played over just G7 as well. It would sound great because it is so tonic driven. Now, I just hinted at this idea of using the sound of the blues in these no-5-2-5s. I like that term, no-5-2-5. It makes sense to me somehow. Oscar uses this all the time, and this is like a go-to. What this is really that exclamation point. This is putting some really heavy punctuation at the end of your phrases. Let's go back to that C-Jam Blues live in Copenhagen and check out how Oscar uses the sound of the blues, right? These notes that are between the notes, you know, that flat five, the major minor third rubbed together. You can hear that all over his playing and all at the end of these phrases on the 5-1 cadences, the no five, two fives. Check it out. Right? Let's hear that again. So happens fast here, but check it out. We'll go a bar right before. Again, in his left hand, he's definitely playing a D7 and not a D minor 7. But there is, so you might think, oh, a D7, well, we have that G flat, that could, it's an F sharp, maybe that's the third of D. Yeah, maybe, but look what happens right after that. Goes down to F natural. That's the blues right there. And look what happens after that on the G7. Right? And then straight down this. Now, I'm not going to use the words blues scale here because this is not what it's about. And I don't think Oscar was thinking about that as like a scale of note choices. It doesn't seem to me that any of the masters were really thinking about that as like a mode to create a sound. It's more about these bends in between the third, the bends in between the fifth, the bends around the tonic. That's what we're thinking about when we're thinking about the sound of the blues. We're thinking about, you know, that kind of thing that the human voice could do, that, you know, a horn can do, that on the piano we have to do those bends with other techniques. But that's what we're getting here, you know. Even here, like you might think he would do something like that, but it's down that pentatonic scale. There's even that A natural in there. That's all part of it, right? Another example we have of this is from this amazing recording of Brotherhood of Man. This is Oscar with the incredible Clark Terry. And this is in the key of E flat. And this is a 2-5-1. It's actually a 3-6-2-5-1. So there's a little bit more of a buildup. We're in the key of E flat here. And there's the very end of the phrase, a 3-6-2-5. And again, the sound of the blues is there. There's no like, there's none of that. There's no spelling out. Here's the seventh. Here's the third, seventh, third. It's all the sound of the blues. Check it out. That's all it is. Let's hear it again. What a sound. I mean, to me, that is such a defining sound, a signature sound for Oscar. And again, it's really quite simple and it's really beautiful. So again, this is kind of a fast 3-6-2-5, all dominant chords. Why not do that at the end? This is also happening at the end of like a 16 bar form, right? So it's happening right at the end after a bunch of stuff has already happened. And I think it's such a beautiful example here of that no 5-2-5. When I say no 5-2-5, I mean, we're not spelling out clearly, we are on the five, now we are on the one. It's all the one. And it's all of these heavy tonics, all of the sound of the blues that gets us that grounded one sound over the five chord. So there's just no delineation between five and one. It's all just this one sound that happens, and that is the sound. Now, in my humble opinion, I think this works best when Oscar combines this really, really heavy tonic sound, like really sticking with the one, and then makes an extra punctuation with more of the sound of the blues, those in-between notes, those heavier notes at the end to really bring it home. He does this in our C-Jam Blues. He does this all the time. And so you can check out this example I have here. We're gonna listen to the whole chorus so you get set up. I mean, come on, let's hear that again. Right, and it's not like Oscar doesn't use functional harmony here. Right before our written example, there's an A7, there's a six chord, and he spells it out perfectly. He lays it clearly down there. But when he gets here to the D minor seven, or the D7, I should say, the two chord, look what happens. It's D7. I mean, that is When the Saints Go Marching In C. Like, that's a C triad. Right, with the little, and then on the five chord, those in-between notes. What a great combination. Let's listen to that again. Oh, it's so good. You know, and this happens too, not only in our C-Jam Blues, but it happens in our Brotherhood of Man. Let's listen to the top of the form of this so you can hear how he sets this up. But again, this is a 3-6-2-5 at the end of the section. Right great is that? Don't you want to do that? I want to do that. I don't know if I could do it that fast right now, but... So good. Ooh, so good. That is where it's at right there. So what are we doing here? We're laying on the tonic. Literally laying on the tonic. An E flat. And we're going to hit those notes that are in between, right? In the cracks there. That flat third over, you know, what you might consider the flat third over a major third. Flat third that's within the major third. The flat third that's within all of our souls. You know what I'm saying? But that is where it gets you. So great. All that over a 3-6-2-5. You know, and again, the real key takeaway here is don't be so precious with trying to spell out every single chord. When all else fails, and especially if you're at the end of phrases, if you're at the end of forms, go to the one. Try a no 5-2-5, and you're going to feel like you're walking in Oscar Peterson's shoes. I mean, it is that distinctive, and it's so much fun. And the best part is, it's way easier than trying to spell out every single chord. You just got to think of the tonic. You got to think of those notes in the cracks. Well, that's it for me. Check out the link to our Language of the Masters course in the description. Until next time, happy practicing.